Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to make image gallery by using HTML and CSS 3. So as you can see here, you can have next and previous button. You can have cross button to close the image. And when you hover on image, it will change the color. So let's begin. First of all, you need to create one folder. I have created a folder called photo gallery. In that folder, I have one image and I can folder, and you can see there are 8 images which I'll use for the image gallery. Now, I'm using Microsoft Dreamweaver as editor. So whatever editor you are using, you can use that. You need to click on File, New, select Basic Page, HTML and create. So here, let's type a simple heading by using H1 tag, image gallery, and save this file inside the photo gallery folder. So I am giving name my gallery .html. Let's see inside the browser. As you can see, our heading is left hand side. Now create another file, basic page, and you need to create CSS file, and you need to save that file. So before you save the file, you need to create the CSS folder. So here I need to create CSS folder. And I'll also create one folder which we required later, and it is JS for jQuery. Save this file inside the CSS folder, and I'll give name style.css. So here I'm declaring body. Write font family sans, sheriff. Okay, now let's define H1 tag. Text align. Center, color, forest, green, and font size, 25px. Let's see in our browser. Okay, so I need to attach this file in HTML documents, which I forgot. So in head section, link, type CSS, REL, select style sheet, href, and you need to select the file which wants to use. Now, as you can see, it's in center and the color is forest green. Now, we are going to create div tag, and I'm going to give name of class is gallery. Inside the div tag, I am giving image, and I'll select image from images folder. So I need all these images. So what I'll do, I'll just copy and paste. So it's less time consuming. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and one more, which is 8. Here I need to simply change the name of file. So this file is PNG, so I need to change the extension as well. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So we have now attached all 8 files, and as you can see, all our images are in our page now. So once you have created these images, and to go into this style sheet, here we can say gallery, which is the class name of div tag, which contains all the images. And to set up the margin, for example, 10px by 200px. And you can set up padding by px. So now you need to go inside the image. So dot gallery means class gallery, which contains image. Here you need to give the width of all the images. I am giving 230px and padding, as you can say, 5px. So you don't need padding here, I think. Then you need to make all that images black and white gray. So here you need to say gray scale 100%. Now let's see what happened in our browser. So as you can see, all these images are in sequence, but what I want is, I want 4 images each column, each row. So what I need to do is, after 4th image, 1, 2, 3, 4, I need to write br tag. So as you can see, everything is in perfect row. And also I need to set alignment is equal to center. Now let's see, as you can see, but this color is didn't change. It's still colorful. It should be in black and white. So let's see what happened. We forget to set transition. It should be 1 second. as you can see, there was a colon here, which was an error. So I've removed that. Filter colon grayscale 100. And now you can see all these images become black and white. Now I need to create the hover effect. When I hover on these images, it should change the color to its original color. So for that, we need to say dot gallery image hover, then we need to again define filter gray scale. This time it should be 0. Transform scale 1.1. Let's see. Now, as you can see, if your cursor is on that image, it's changing the color. Okay, so it was a simple hover effect. Now we need to apply lightbox. To apply lightbox, you need to search lightbox jQuery in Google. Click on this website, the first website. Click on GitHub and download the file from here. Once you download your file, I'm just moving this file to files to the desktop. So after that, you need to just simply extract the file. I got already that folder here because I extracted before, so I'm not doing that. You just simply need to extract here, yeah, and then I am deleting this one because I don't need it. You will have this box, this folder. So go into that folder. You will have dist folder. In that folder, you will have CSS folder. So copy lightbox main file and paste it inside the photo gallery folder where you have CSS folder. Go back to the lightbox folder again, which we have downloaded. Go inside the JS folder. You have another file called lightbox plus jQuery.main. Copy that file, paste inside the JS folder, which is inside the photo gallery folder. Once you have copied and pasted the folders inside files inside the folder, then you need to give the anchor link to all these images to give the lightbox effect. So here, what I need to do is again href and to select the file. Save and let's see what happened to our program. I need to open from here. So if I'll click on this, it will open the link. Okay, so all I need to do is now I need to give the link to all of that images. Okay, so I need to change the file name, it's PNG. Then 4, number 5, 6, 7, and 8. So now we have given the anchor link to all of our images which we can open. Now we need to set up the lightbox. So in our HTML file, we need to link the lightbox.css, which we have copied and pasted from the lightbox folder. Arial, it's style sheet, href. Go to the photo gallery, go into the CSS folder and select lightbox main.css. Now you need to select another file which is for your jQuery. So you need to select script, type text or JavaScript, source, you need to select from JS file, last lightbox plus jQuery main. Close the script. Now you need to give data lightbox attribute here, data light light box is equal to, you can give any name you want to give. I am just giving gallery here. Okay, let's see what happened. So now as you can see, it's opened in lightbox, but I have not set up that cross arrow, previous and next arrow, cross button and previous and next arrow here. So now we need to do that. As you can see, now it's not working because I have applied on this one only. So we need to copy and paste this to each and every anchor links. So as you can see, now I have copied and pasted, and now it's working for every image. And as you can see, image 2 of 8, image 3 of 8. Now we need to simply give the images of cross, forward and backward arrow. For that, again you need to go to the lightbox folder which we have downloaded. You will see the images here in image folder. Simply copy and paste all that into the image folder and then go to the browser, refresh the page, and if you see now, you will have cross arrow, you will have forward arrow because it's the first image, you will not see the previous arrow. Once you will be on second image, you will see the previous arrow and next arrow, and you can close your image. Now one more thing we need to add is, we need to give the title of this image. So that we can do from here, title, and that is meditation. Title, again meditation. Or we can say morning meditation and evening meditation. You can type in capital as well if you want to show more particularly. Morning meditation, evening meditation. Title, title. We just copy and paste quickly. Antarmona. Yog Nindra. Tamangasana. Padma Mayur. Asana. Purna Tanurasana. And Padma Rushik Asana. Let's see what happened. Now, as you can see, you can have the title as well. If you want to make it more fancy, if you want a background color, then you can simply go into the style.css file, where you can simply say background color in your gallery class, background color, and you can simply select any of the color you like. And then if you see, you can have background color as well. So this was the simple and very effective method to create, to make the photo gallery. There are different ways as well. If you want the same size, like thumbnail size, and when you click on that, it becomes the all these images should open in with the same size, then you can use two different images here. So here you can show the small image, thumbnail image, and here you can see the same size image of all these images. So you need copy of that images, like small copy and large copy. So for here example, all the images are not opening in same size because they are different size and different shape. So if you want same size images, you can do that also. Simply you need to change the image in anchor link here. So that was the tutorial today. If you like the video, please do subscribe, share, and give me thumbs up. Thank you so much.